Welcome to this guided tour in Access Audio Manager Edge. In this video, I will show you the general features and settings in Edge, and how simple it is to set up and manage. The learning goal for this video is for you to feel familiar with the tool. If you wish to learn even more about the setup and Edge, I advise you to take a look in the online manual for Access Audio Manager Edge, or to visit access.com to find more information and all available support material on the product. When you've connected your speakers in your system to the network, log into one of them and you'll see that there's a new button to open Access Audio Manager Edge. The first time you do this, you'll get to name your site. Now, since we've created the Edge system on this device, it will become the leader in our system. This is the dashboard. Here you get a swift overview of active devices, what the system is playing at the moment, and the agenda of what is scheduled for today and tomorrow. In the bottom furthest down, you have a quick link to open Access Audio Manager Edge on this device. Let's save that for the future. Under Apps, we have available apps in Edge, which help us to control our system. Since we are the admins for this system, we can see all available apps. Edge is clever, and we can create accounts for coworkers with limited authority to configure the system. In their case, they will only be able to see apps allowed for them to see. I'll show you this a bit later on. The first thing we want to do is to add our remaining speakers on the network to our Edge system. We find the app for that in the bottom called Physical Zones. In this example, we are installing 4 speakers for a small grocery store. The site owner wants 1 speaker in the staff area for paging, 2 speakers in the customer area to play music and announcement, and 1 speaker specifically over the counter where the music is a bit quieter. So we'll create 3 zones. The next thing we're going to do is to set up paging functionality. The manager has a 2N SIPMIC located in the back office through which live announcements out to the system can be played. Let's set that up. We can do this under paging sources. In order to add a paging source to the system, we first need to establish a connection between a microphone and a speaker in our system. This is done outside Edge. You can connect a paging source to a speaker either through Vapix or SIP. If you want to see how this is done, you can take a look in the online manual for Access Audio Manager Edge, where we have created step-by-step guides for this. Once a paging source, like the button of a SIPMIC, has been addressed to a speaker, what we see under paging sources is not the microphone, but the speaker receiving the signal from the microphone. Because of this, it's important to remember to establish the connection from our paging sources to different speakers. This will allow us to easily configure the incoming calls to the zones which we want them to play. Once a paging source has a connection, you can freely choose where you want it to page. In other words, just because you have established a connection between a microphone and a specific speaker doesn't mean that you have to page to that speaker specifically. I have now connected 3 of the SIP mics buttons, each transmitting to the different speakers in the system. I've done this using SIP, so now I can set up where I want each button to page. I want the first button to page to all speakers in the system. The second one should only page to the staff area. The third button should page to all speakers in the customer area. To the left, we have a priority list where we can arrange our paging sources based on priority. A paging source with higher priority will always trump lower ones. Live paging always takes priority over music, announcements, or ads. If our site would have been much larger and had many more zones, we could have also created a paging zone, which combines speakers and physical zones as we need. This can simplify a larger setup. The next thing we'll want to do is to create different users for our system. In this case, the store will have three different user types. One will be the IT manager, Greg, who has the overall responsibility for the system. He will have an administrator account. Next, we'll have Tina. She is the local store manager, and she will get a content management account through which she can control advertisements, announcements, music, music volume, and the opening hours. Note that she can't change the volume for announcements or paging. These should always be set to a specific loudness so that important paging or safety messages are always heard throughout the site. Lastly, we have Paul, Megan, and Susan. They are staff and they run the front end of the store. They will each get a volume user account, which means that they can change the volume of the music as they need. To change the music volume in the system, music volume users don't necessarily have to log in to a computer. They can simply download the Access Volume app, log in, connect to adjust the music volume as they need in the different zones. Next, let's set our opening hours for this site. The reason we do this is so that the system can automatically adjust announcements for opening and closing messages relative to your opening hours instead of being played at fixed times. Our site will have opening hours between 8 to 17 all working days and 8 to 15 on weekends. Next, let's add some opening and closing announcements. We'll upload our announcement clips to the library. Next, we create opening announcements. We select our clip, we select it to be relevant to the opening hours and that it plays during all days of the week. Done. The same procedure goes for the closing one. Now we're also going to add one saying that the store closes in 15 minutes. For this one, we can add that it's played 15 minutes before closing. We want to play these in the customer area, so we select these zones for our announcement schedule. Next, let's go ahead and add some advertisement. This function explains itself quite naturally for a large grocery store or a retail chain, but for our small grocery store, we don't want ads. So instead, we're going to use this feature to play reoccurring safety messages. First, let's add the zones in which we want these messages to be played in. Upload our safety messages to the library. Next, we add an advertisement schedule, schedule the day, starting and end time, and select a message from our library. Lastly, we set this clip to play once every 20 minutes. Done. Every 20 minutes, we'll have a safety message playing. And once again, this could also be used for advertisements or any other kind of message that you want to play reoccurringly. Remember to maintain at least 1 meter of distance between yourself and other people, particularly if they're coughing or sneezing. Thank you for shopping with us, and thank you for your cooperation. Next, let's add some music. Under sources, we can add music in different ways, through a line-in, using an audio bridge, for example, web stream, or an ACAP. In this case, our store will be playing BBC Radio Channel 1 during opening hours. To add a web stream, you need a streaming link like this M3U link. Most radio channels have web streaming links available online. It's most often just a Google search away. Now that I have web radio playing, that's great. But should it fall silent due to bad internet connection, I wouldn't want my music to go silent in the whole store. So we're also going to upload some music stored locally on the mini SD card inserted into the back of the speaker. This can work as fallback music if the internet connection to the web radio should go down. We want to play these in the customer area. Let's take a look at volume levels. We'll skip the music volumes and jump straight into the volume calibration app instead. Here we can set our default music levels for each song. We can calibrate the volume for paging sources, announcements, and advertisements. In this case, our safety messages. Now, let's go back, because if one of the coworkers screws up the music volumes at any point, you can reset it to default volume by clicking the reset button in the music volume app. Our system is now ready. I hope you have found this walkthrough useful. Bye-bye.